everybody. We're going to do some sweet stretches today, focusing on the hips and the hamstrings. So it would help if you had the equivalent of a strap, so a necktie or a towel. Pantyhose work great too. And then you might need a couple blankets just in case you like to prop, or you'll need to prop yourself up in some of the stretches, okay? Otherwise, we're gonna start on hands and knees. So, not so important to line the hips and the knees and the shoulders and the wrists up, but always a good idea. And we'll just begin with some easy spinal stretches here, undulating, separating the shoulder blades and bringing the shoulder blades together and arching the back. And then we'll move, kind of adding the hips. So you might want to separate the knees a little bit, and it's okay if the feet come in slightly. Sit back on the heels. And then come back up to that hands and knees position. And if you'd like to come forward, it feels kind of good too. Inhale here, and then exhale, sitting back on the heels. Now here's where the blanket could come in handy. You could put a blanket underneath, on top of your heels, because sometimes sitting back on the heels isn't accessible right away. And so when we move like this, we release a fluid in our body that acts as a lubricant, kind of prepping the hips for what's to come. A couple more times here. Good. And then back to hands and knees. Now aligning up the knees right under the hips again and having the knees be hip width apart. Lift your right leg in the air, and we're just going to drop the right knee behind the left until you feel your left thigh kind of fire and engage, okay? And then come back up. And now open your right hip to your degree. And then close the hip back down and ease the weight back towards your left shin. I just want to get the legs warm a little bit before we go right into the stretch. So I went for a beautiful long walk, two of them, actually with one friend, Heather, and then an afternoon walk with my friend Daniela. And nothing feels better after those long walks than a nice stretch for the hips, because you get so tight. And let's do the other side. So left leg lifts, and then you can see on the video now it comes back and you kind of lean back, getting into this right glute hip area. And then if you press down into the right shin, you can kind of fire up the quadricep too. Yeah, just easy back and forth. You might want some kind of padding underneath the knee if your knee and shin feel tender. A couple more times. That's it. Good, and then we'll just come to a crisscross applesauce, come to seated. Now, this is one of those things that sitting might be really uncomfortable for you, and if it is, that's fine. Just put your blanket underneath your bottom and feel a lot better. So inhale, bring your arms overhead, and then rolling out your wrists, bring your hands down to the ground. And then bring your left arm more towards the center, and then twist, easy twist to the right. If you want to take it deeper, you put your left hand on the outside of the right thigh, give a little twist. And then we'll do the same thing on the other side. Now, your right leg, if your right leg is forward, just kind of be mindful which leg's forward because we're going to do it on each side. So slide your hands forward, maintaining as flat a back as you can. So use your hands to prop you up and you'll reach that spot right where the right hip or whatever leg is forward feels your stretch. So go as deep as you can and we'll hold this stretch. So there's something to this holding of the stretch. So I know back in the day we used to bounce in and out. It was called ballistic stretching, but we don't do that now. Now it's more about holding. And there's a certain point, and there's lots of different science arguments behind it, but I find 90 seconds seems to be the number. And we can actually allow things to release. So have a little patience with me today. Yeah. Just breathe and wait for your body to let you in. Something that's been bothering you. Or find a part of your body that has some tension in it, including this right hip, of course, but maybe something in the neck, maybe something in the low back. Just let it go with your breath. Attention to those spots that need your care right now, that need a little tenderness. I know everybody's been kind of cooped up, right? And it's wonderful to be with family, I know it is, but no matter how great relationships are, okay, this is a great example of no two sides are the same. So switch the cross of your legs. It'll be your funny side. Yeah. And then fall forward into this forward fold. And wait. So there's this initial reaction of, oh my God, I'm so sore. Or, oh my gosh, I'm so tight. And then we breathe past, if we sit in it long enough, and we ungrip that initial fear grip, you know, like, oh God, I don't want to hurt myself. If you back out just enough, and then you sit in this stretch, and you wait for things to melt, visualizing things melting, then you really begin to get the benefit of these stretches. Hang in there. Stay with me. Use this time as a meditation. And you're meditating on yourself. You're meditating on sensation. The language that your body uses to speak to you. Feeling. When you extend your right leg, you can sit. sit up a little bit taller because we've lifted our hips. And then bring your left leg so it's kind of in a butterfly pose. And then forward fold. And here's another time you could use your blanket. I like to here. If I roll up the blanket and I lay the rib cage on the blanket, then it fosters this flat back that we're looking for. Take an inhale here and then exhale. Forward fold over the right leg. Stretching like this, it's a different kind of workout. So here we're exercising patience. Exercising what in the yoga world we call ahimsa or kindness. Because we bump into things like flexibility issues. And if we meet those issues with kindness instead of, you know, self-criticism, this will go a long way. Once the body lets you in here, you can maybe relax a little bit over the right leg. Maybe relax the muscles in the face. Relax the muscles in the neck. Forearms, and if you want to allow the heads to feel supported, you can place your forehead in your hands, the most flexible of you might be able to lay completely on the right thigh, but find your spot. And then as you're here, the spot changes and we have to kind of go explore and look for something new. And looking for something new could be simply walking your hands over to the left. That's a deep one for me. They say the hips, you know, they're our storage depot. Emotional baggage tends to end up there, deep in the nooks and crannies. But it's also simply just the biggest joint. Biggest muscle group, so no doubt it's the tightest. Now, you've walked yourself over to the left. Try walking yourself over to the right. Flexing through the right foot. And if you're going to pull anything, try putting a little extra pressure on the right ankle. Trying to keep the right ankle and the right knee in the same plane. And then the tailbone, if it curls up, I'd like you to try to press the tailbone towards the floor, because that's a little safer for the low back. A couple more breaths here. And then put the feet on the floor and let the knees fall over to the right. And roll yourself up to seated, and we'll do everything on the other side. So you might need to prop yourself up again on your blanket, but extend the left leg out in front of you. Bring the right knee up to the right. Take an inhale, sit up as tall as you can, and then exhale forward fold. Left foot does a couple things. One, it kind of moves the stretch not just from the hamstring but also down the calf. And the other thing it does is it engages through the left thigh. And I find if the left thigh is engaged, there's a less chance of overstretching through the hamstring. But if you use your sensation as your guide, you should never really overstretch because you're in control here, you're in charge. Find your own edge. Doing these kind of stretches at home, the benefit is is a few. One, you can do them in your pajamas before you go to bed, because forward folds like these are very soothing. Two, you're not looking around. There's something about flexibility that if you've got a room full of people, there's just a lot of competition goes on with that, and there's really nothing to compare to because nobody has your genetic makeup or your background or your history in sports or your history of injuries, your activity level, your eating habits. So it's kind of silly to think that one person should look just like another. So meet your body where it is and be kind to your body. And it'll be kind back to you. A couple more breaths here. to the side. Alright, let's work the hips in another way. So first, bring your heels together. Knees are going to be apart. And then forward folding with as flat a back as you can here. So you can slide your hands forward. Now I'm going to turn sideways for a second because I want you to see what I mean. This isn't possible. Try sitting on your blanket. Yep, and that props your hips up, and the flat back might be a little more accessible. You won't have to go that far. It's inches. It's centimeters, really. So you're going to either stay like this, okay? Or you open the legs out to the side. Now, I'd like you to try to keep your feet pointed up to the sky when you forward fold. A lot of times people's feet came in and there's some knee and hip stuff that could happen. And I'm not there to watch or anything, so you're your own boss here. But my suggestion is to make sure your toes are pointed up to the sky, and then we fall forward as until your body says, please don't fall forward anymore. Yeah, but find your inner groin stretch here. Butterfly seated pose or the spread leg, walk your hands back. And then from butterfly, all you'll do is slide your feet out a little more so your legs are in a diamond shape. And then if you're in spread leg, come to this diamond shape. Now, again, you might want to have something near you that you can put on top of your feet, because most of us are going to need to bring the feet closer to our head. And we're going to round our back here and lay your forehead on something, okay? Whether it's blankets or a pillow, whatever you need. And I'll turn in profile so you can see what I mean by rounding the back. Yeah. So that first one we were working with square shoulders. This one, we're working in a hollowed out back, and we let gravity do its thing here. You might not need anything, and you might enjoy that 8 or 10 pounds extra that the head gives you as gravity. It's a hip stretch, but it's also a delicious spinal flexion, separating the vertebrae. You can begin that stretching feeling from the sacrum up each one of the lumbar vertebrae, creating space behind the lungs and the heart, the thoracic vertebrae stretching, shoulder blades spreading. Tuck of the chin lengthens through the neck. Possibly resting the forehead on the feet. postures is teaching myself to become more patient. This one's, you know, you just go to your little edge, right? do that stack log or double pigeon on this side. So now the right shin will be on top of the left shin. So we gotta be kind of mindful of the ankle. I know a lot of people put their foot in this crease, but this kind of kink in the ankle could potentially run up to the knee and not be so great for you. So see if you can put the foot on the outside. And then you might want to put the blanket right there. Inhale here and then forward fold. You stay right there. I'm going to get the music going. I don't know what stopped. And that wasn't my trick to get out of it.
Strength.
right foot in the strap. So put your left foot on the floor and have your left knee bent, because when the left leg is outstretched, you have a tendency to allow the back to arch, and I'd like you to keep your back on the floor because it's safer. And then loop the strap around the right foot, the ball of the foot and not the arch if possible. And then you're going to be in charge here on how far to pull the right leg in. So you get a good, sweet touch for the right hamstring. You'll know when you're in it. So what I want you to do is imagine that your right leg is the hand of a clock. And right now your right leg is at 12 o'clock. Without letting your right hip come off the floor, I want you to bring your right leg to 11 o'clock or until your right leg says you found something very deep. And we'll stay here. I call this the ay 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 stretch, because whenever I find it, I think to myself, ay ay ay. Now the ball of the foot, having the strap there is key, because if you pull down, then you can access the calf and the Achilles as well. Now, what'll happen is that ay-ay-ay feeling will go away, and that's wonderful, but you need to go find a new ay-ay-ay feeling. And a micro movement can get you there. The other direction. So put the straps, both of them, in your right hand. And then open your left arm out to the left. It's going to be your counterbalance. And then let your left thigh fall over to the left. And then just gradually, with the hands on the strap to keep your right leg from falling out of control, open your right leg out to the right. Gazing over the left arm is a nice twist for the neck. Now, bring the right leg back up so you're back at 12 o'clock, and then switch the straps so that both straps are in the left hand. And then bring the right arm out to the right. Straighten your left leg along the floor. And then easily just guide your right leg. Now you've got your strap, that's your control. And send the right leg all the way over as far as your body says is okay, over to the left. Looking over the right arm. Thank you. left knee. And then use this strap and bend your left knee and drive your left knee towards your chest for another version of a figure four stretch. The sacrum down towards the floor if you can. Now, the right foot is going to come to the floor and we'll begin the series again on the left leg. So put a strap in each hand and just pull your left leg in. Creating space. You're creating space in your body. After this, you're going to get up and move with a lightness. stretch for the psoas. So while we're here, let's take that time. So